Thank you very much, Director of Ceremony. Your Excellency Amina J. Mohammed, Deputy Secretary General of the United Nations, Your Excellency Ambassador Malet Hailu, Permanent Secretary for Europe, the Americas, Asia, and Multilateral Affairs in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia, Your Excellency Dr. Vera Songwe, Executive Secretary of the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa, as well as Under Secretary General of the United Nations, Your Excellencies, Ambassadors and Heads of Mission here present, Your Excellencies, Heads of the UN agencies in the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I stand before you on behalf of His Excellency Moussa Faki Mahamat, Chairperson of the African Union Commission. He is unable to be with us this morning because of other official engagements outside Addis Ababa. On his behalf, and on behalf of all the AUC staff, I warmly congratulate the United Nations for this very historic day. We are observing a momentous occasion. A very small book, the Charter of the United Nations, has been a force for good throughout the world since its entry into force in 1945. The successes of the Charter and through it, the UN system, is wide-ranging and can only mention a few areas: peace and security, conflict resolution, peacemaking and peace building, human rights, migration, humanitarian assistance, education, health, electoral assistance, and among others, sustainable development. The theme for this year, Greening the Blue, captures the challenge and promise of sustainable development. The challenge is that our pursuit of progress as human beings is also accompanied by inducing environmental calamities. And here I can mention a few again, of the challenges of pollution, global warming, sea level rise, drought, desertification, and loss of biological diversity, among others. The promise is that the world is enhancing actions to meet the challenge. I accompanied His Excellency Moussa Faki Mahamat to this year's Climate Change Summit at the United Nations headquarters in New York. At that summit, the young generation was blaming us, the elder generation, for this growing environmental challenge, which is transforming into an existential threat for humankind and our planet. The promise is that this young generation will not allow this existential threat to run its course. As we celebrate this day, let us therefore dedicate our first efforts to save SERVE and save SAVE, our physical environment, for present and future generations. Let us use the UN Charter to galvanize ourselves. Let us use greening the blue. And I may add, when you use that, we'll be able to advance our common future. As the African Union, we are happy to celebrate this historic day with the rest of humanity. The UN is our partner in progress. The Organization of African Union, the Organization of African Unit, the forerunner to the African Union, was founded in this compound at Africa Hall. The UN is very active in providing economic and technical assistance in EU member states. At the level of the African Union, our collaboration with the UN is gaining momentum in a wide range of fields such as peace and security, climate change, youth empowerment, regional and continental economic integration, food security, among others. We look forward to deepening this collaboration, and I'll conclude by wishing continued success for the UN system under the Charter. Thank you.